I'm excited about saving the world with nuclear power. I know some of you are going to react Fukushima, so I'd like to help you learn more about liquid fuel nuclear reactors and the energetic humanitarians, the people who are spending their lives trying to perfect this technology to solve the world problems. Let's first look at some of those problems. 3 billion people cook and heat indoors by burning solid fuels such as wood and cattle dung. 3 million a year die from the resulting indoor air pollution. A two-burner hot plate could address this problem, except that over 1 billion people have no access to electricity. Outdoor air pollution from industrial growth kills millions, kills 1 million people a year in China, thousands in the US. Burning coal is the major culprit. Global warming is intensified by CO2 emissions from burning coal. A major harm is reduced food production from reduced water flows as glaciers are disappearing. As our world population grows from 6 to 9 billion people, we increase the competition for natural resources such as food and oil, and the competition can lead to war. On this chart, each dot represents a nation's average birth rate and personal income. Notice that the poorest nations have the most population growth, and that population stability occurs at about 2.3 births per woman. At a prosperity of about $7,500, populations are stable or shrinking. Prosperity gives women time off from continual chores of food preparation, child raising, housekeeping, with time off for education, jobs, money, independence, and freedom for personal choices about reproduction. It takes electricity to achieve prosperity. Electricity for households, industry, commerce, water, sanitation, refrigeration, and so on. The crossover is about 2,000 kilowatt hours a year. This much electricity costs as little as $100 in the wealthy nations and as much as $1,000 in the others. Developing nations need electricity to achieve their prosperity. So global electricity demand is increasing. They'll need the power of 2,300 more giant 1 gigawatt power stations to achieve this. Conservation and efficiency in the developing nations can't help much because the future demand is so much larger. For India, poverty is more important than emissions. Developing nations already plan to double the world's number of coal-burning power plants. I'm excited about solving these global crises, pollution, climate, and poverty, with safe, clean, cheaper atomic energy from liquid fuels. United States President Dwight Eisenhower entered this brave new space at the United Nations. Eisenhower asked the great powers to end the nuclear arms race and instead use that technology to provide abundant electrical energy to humanity. Alvin Weinberg earned 3 degrees from the University of Chicago, and then he worked on the Manhattan Project with famous physicists Teller, Szilard, and Nobel Prize winners like Compton, Wigner, and Fermi. He invented the pressurized water nuclear reactor, which was well suited to power a submarine. Abrasive, demanding Admiral Rickover successfully launched the first nuclear-powered submarine in 1955. enjoying Eisenhower's confidence, Rickover convinced the world to build more of these solid-fueled, water-cooled reactors that he, Rickover, had pioneered. Meanwhile, Weinberg, director of Oak Ridge, developed a different kind of nuclear reactor, one which used liquid fuels at low pressure and high temperature. In this table, atomic elements are displayed in the columns and atomic masses in the rows. In a nuclear reactor, neutrons absorbed by uranium-238 are transmuted to plutonium-239 fuel that makes the reactor run. Similarly, thorium is converted to uranium-233 fuel for that reactor. Because thorium is plentiful, this process promises an inexhaustible source of energy for all of humanity's future. Weinberg also noticed the buildup of atmospheric CO2 from burning coal. He predicted climate change. His 1976 warnings to Congress fell on deaf ears. Weinberg also expressed concerns about the safety of larger and larger pressurized water reactors. This led to his firing and to the end of molten salt reactor research at Oak Ridge. Edward Teller was born here in Austria-Hungary. He earned his PhD in quantum mechanics under Werner Heisenberg. When Hitler took power, Teller left, went to the United States, and later joined the Manhattan Project. Known for his development of the H-bomb, Teller was also concerned with the safety of nuclear power plants. Teller wanted a reactor so safe that school children could run it. He developed the safe TRIGA reactor, demonstrated before a crowd in San Diego. Its control rods were ejected, and the reactor power jumped to 1,000 times its 1 megawatt design capability. The reactor shut itself down safely in just 2 milliseconds. Such passive safety comes from the physics of the instantly heated fuel and moderator, not from electronics or moving parts. A TRIGA reactor is now safely operated by students at Reed College in the United States, and there's one here in Vienna. Later in life, Teller became interested in a walkaway safe nuclear power plant, the molten salt reactor. Nearly blind, he worked with my friend Ralph Moore to revise draft after draft of their design for an underground power plant. Concerned about his aging mind, Teller prepared himself for these meetings by breathing oxygen in a special hyperbaric chamber he had installed in his home. Their article about a liquid fuel nuclear reactor was accepted for publication just before Teller died. Kirk Sorensen earned his first master's degree in aerospace engineering when he worked at NASA. Kirk was conceiving a lunar colony power plant fueled by the moon's thorium. He came across Weinberg's mothballed Oak Ridge work on molten salt reactors. If such a power plant would work on the moon, why not on the Earth? The Oak Ridge work was scanned and posted, and Kirk created an internet forum to share ideas about molten salt reactors. Concerned about the future for his own children, Kirk is teaching them science. Here are two of them, his youngest daughters, reciting the periodic table.
You can go fast and say it in a loud voice.
Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
I'm an advisor to Kirk's company, Flybe Energy, founded to make a molten salt reactor that runs sustainably on just thorium. Neutrons are produced by the uranium fission in the yellow central circle. Some of them pass into the green blanket, where they transmute thorium into uranium. From the fission products created by splitting uranium atoms, Kirk expects to extract medical isotopes such as technetium-99, which is used in hospitals to create radiopharmaceuticals for brain and heart imaging. Per Peterson's father was a professor of soils science. Traveling and camping with him across Nevada, Per became an environmentalist. Per earned his PhD from the University of California at Berkeley. Then he conducted research that contributed to the passive safety of nuclear reactors such as the new Westinghouse AP1000. Peterson was a member of the Blue Ribbon Commission on America's Nuclear Future, where he invited me to speak. As chair of nuclear engineering at Berkeley, Per taught tomorrow's engineers, and he also participated in Sorensen's Forum, inspiring others to design molten salt reactors. Per is now testing components of molten salt-cooled reactors, a stepping stone to liquid fuel reactors. Liquid fuel is the key technology that differentiates molten salt reactors from today's water-cooled solid fuel reactors. Molten salt can safely get hotter, there's nothing solid to break, and it can't melt down because it's already liquid. Bill Gates learned Dartmouth Basic programming on his school's teletypewriter when I was providing basic time-sharing services from Dartmouth's computer center. He went on to found Microsoft. Now his philanthropy extends to global health and global development. Here's what Gates had to say about the importance of energy in his TED Talk.
It's a very concrete wish that we invent this technology. If you gave me only one wish for the next 50 years, I can pick who's president, I can pick a vaccine, which is something I love, or I could pick that this thing that's half the cost with no CO2 gets invented. This is the wish I would pick. This is the one with the greatest impact.
Gates is a founder of TerraPower, a company that is developing a liquid sodium-cooled solid fuel reactor. Their company is also investigating liquid fuel reactors. Mianheng Zhang is the son of the former president of China. He earned a PhD in superconductivity at Drexel University in the U.S. He read an American Scientist article by Ralph Moore and me and decided to visit Oak Ridge to learn more. He secured $350 million of funding and support from the Chinese Academy of Sciences to build molten salt reactors in China. Here I am signing my book for Zhang in Shanghai. In his own talks, Zhang uses this slide to emphasize the need for clean energy to help overcome the industrial pollution in China. Intrinsic safety comes from physical principles. The normally solid plug of salt melts if the liquid fuel overheats, draining the dissolved uranium, stopping the reactor. All nuclear reactors contribute and continue to generate decay heat after shutdown. That's the heat that damaged the solid fuel rods at Fukushima. Molten salt fuel can safely rise to very high temperatures, and then that heat is radiated away from the drain tank. David LeBlanc from New Brunswick earned his PhD in superconductivity at the University of Ottawa. During an interlude at Atomic Energy Canada, David became interested in nuclear power. He taught physics at Carleton College, but on the side, kept studying liquid fuel reactors. Married to a medical doctor with two kids, he became a stay-at-home dad with more time to study molten salt reactors. He's founded Terrestrial Energy in Canada to develop a molten salt reactor there. Potentially, it will supply heat for extracting bitumen from tar sands reducing CO2 emissions from that process. Jack Devaney earned his PhD in naval architecture from MIT, later teaching there. He left academia to design, build, and operate the world's largest ocean-going vessels. Jack designed Thorcon to utilize modern, high-precision shipyard manufacturing techniques to make nuclear power plants. He chose liquid fuel technologies because of the economic potential to displace coal, because of the inherent safety of liquid fuel, and because of the $1 billion of documented R&D done by Oak Ridge. Jack asked me to publish his complete Thorcon design. It is now public, open source, for all to see and use. Thorcon is a low-cost reactor because of the low-pressure liquid fuel, the simple passive safety, and factory production. It's the low cost that will entice nations to stop burning coal to make electricity. Molten salt reactors provide the economic incentive that will entice the developing nations to meet their electricity demands with no CO2 emissions. Leslie Dewan, one of Time Magazine's 30 people under 30 changing the world. Schooled in Boston, she worked designing search and rescue robots. Leslie later enrolled in nuclear engineering at MIT. She founded Transatomic Power, a company that expects to burn waste fuel rods from light water reactors. I'm excited about saving the world with liquid fuel nuclear reactors. These energetic humanitarians foresee prosperity in developing nations with abundant electricity for households, commerce, industry, and public services. For all nations, I envision more use of zero-carbon electricity to power cars and trains, to make aluminum and steel, and to synthesize fuels for trucks and planes. If you gave me one wish, it's that we produce these liquid fuel reactors to supply world electricity safely at half the cost of coal, emitting no CO2. We can accomplish this by mid-century. You've met 9 energetic humanitarians who are seeking to save the world and keep us safe. A part of my wish is that you help people consider the safety and benefits of atomic energy from liquid fuels. Political leaders need to be brave enough to guide people past their old fears. I wish that you help them enter this brave new space.